Hello everyone. In this video, I am going to discuss about how to practice smartly. This will be helpful for both vocal as well as instrument learners. So watch the video till the end and do share it with your friends. You have to remember mainly three tips, that is listening, understanding, playing or singing. So first is listening. For music especially, listening plays 80% of the role. Okay? Listening plays 80% of the role in music. It might be vocal or instrumental. How? First, the basic of the music is the swarasthanas. It might be a film song, it might be a kirtana, it might be a basic of Carnatic music like janta swaras, sarali swaras, etc. The swarasthanas are important. The ragas are important. How are the ragas originated? They come from the swarasthanas itself by different combinations of swarasthanas. So, you have to be perfect with the Dwadasa and Shodasa Swarasthanas. Okay, leave the Shodasa Swarasthanas. Be perfect with the Dwadasa Swarasthanas, that is the 12 Swarasthanas. This is helpful for both vocal as well as instrument learners, because even though you are an instrument player, to write a notation or to identify which swaram that person is singing or which swaram that person is playing, instead of just looking at the position of his or her fingers, don't try to identify. Improve your listening skills, which will help you so much in identifying a swarasthanam or for writing a notation and for especially identifying the ragam. Okay, this listening skill is very much important. This listening should be done with great concentration. Okay, this should be done with great concentration. So there is some pattern of listening. First time when you listen to a video, it might be a tutorial or it might be a whole song or anything. First, listen to the whole video without stopping it. Don't try to grasp anything from that video. Just enjoy that video. The second time when you watch the video, try to grasp some information from that video. If it's a tutorial, first don't try to look at the notation or the information which is given in the description. Try to analyze with the help of your listening knowledge. Okay, what is this particular ragam? What are the swarasthanas coming? So those all you try to analyze when you listen it to the second time. When you listen it to the third time, you will be lightly familiar with the sahityam. Okay, for any song, mainly for film songs or kritis or kirtanas, sahityam is there. So for remembering the sahityam, listen once more. So in this manner, listening also has few steps. Then understanding. Understanding is nothing but not mugging up each and everything. Many people keep asking, how do I remember the notations? How do I remember the dhatuswaras or the geetams or varnams without seeing? First, when you are trying to learn itself, don't try to depend upon the book. It might cheat you by having slight printing mistakes, but your listening skills will not cheat you. So, whatever you try to listen from your guru or from any other video, try to grasp it in your mind. Okay, suppose if you are learning a song, for example, Inkem Inkem Kavali, understand the lyrics. I have posted one video how to play easily and fluently. So for vocal learners also, this will be very helpful. Whatever you are trying to learn, for example, you are learning a varnam, that varnam swaram, when your teacher is teaching you or you are listening it from YouTube, divide it into parts and listen it very carefully and try to learn with listening only. I teach my students all the songs without their knowledge of seeing the book. They just write down the song lyric just for their parents' purpose. So, I don't allow them to open the book in my class. At home, I don't know, because whatever they are learning in the class only, they'll be practicing at home. But in my class, my students, according to my teaching, I won't allow them to open the book. Rather than they remember each and everything which I teach, including Nama Ramayanam also. I guess you have already watched their video. I did not allow them to open the book. Those words which are complicated, I made them repeat it 5 to 6 times. So they remember those words very easily. Don't try to understand each and everything from the book. Bookish knowledge is later. First, listening. Through listening, understand. Understanding is nothing but try to find some logic. For example, in dhatuswaras, there will be some or other logic of framing of those phrases. So, understand the logic and apply. Don't try to depend upon the book. This anyone learning vocal or instrument should remember. This is main point. Okay, no book. Remember this, no book. Don't try to watch the notation. Whatever you are trying to play, for example, you want to play a song, inkem inkem kavale. Notation is given below. But if somebody is teaching it in a tutorial, by listening itself, first try to play a song by listening to the original song. If you are unable to play from the original song, then go for a video with a notation. If that person is singing with the notation or playing with the notation by spelling it out, try to listen and play. Then if you are having any doubts, go to the description box and see. So I am just explaining about my case which is happening. Okay, first try to analyze everything from the video. The video contains so much information, not only my video, any video. For example, if you want to learn Kriti Mahaganapatim, just don't rush to the Google for the lyric. Listen to the one version properly. If that lyric is not pronounced properly, if that audio clarity is not good, go to some other version and where the lyric is very clear, where the audio is very clear, try to listen and try to learn everything with grasping itself. Okay, I have already told you listening plays very much important role. So 80% is listening itself. Then this understanding without the usage of book, try to, by listening only, try to learn everything. Then playing or singing. So playing or singing requires application of gamakams. You might be asking, there are many ragas and many swaras, how to apply the gamakams? I have explained about this gamakam concept. The link is in the description box. Okay, so those gamakams, when you try 2 to 3 items in that ragam, you'll get to know about that ragam. Only once if you play some varnam or geetam in the ragam, Mohana or Shankara varnam, you'll be very perfect with that ragam. No, you have to listen to that ragam very frequently so that, okay, particular swaram is having particular gamakam in this ragam. So if you try to be familiar with that ragam only, you will be able to know each and everything about that ragam. How is the feel of the ragam? So what are the gamakas applied? Where are the gamakas applied? How is the jaru gamakam applied? Etc. will be known. So playing and singing is that understanding. So without seeing the book, first your notation or your song, don't try to memorize everything. That won't help you in the future. Okay, so the notation, okay, slightly outline you can just have, something like India map. Notation is like India map. Playing is different states. Okay, so that outline you are having, okay, it is starting with ni or it is starting with ga. Okay, these here gamakams, this jaru gamakam is in this particular place. That kind of information you try to learn. Otherwise, ni sa ri sa, ni sa ri sa, ni sa ri sa, ni sa ri sa. How many times will you mug up? That doesn't work out. So try to analyze everything with the help of listening. While cooking or while traveling, whatever they are doing, just keep on your earphone and just try to recollect everything while listening itself. This will help you a lot. Hope you have enjoyed this video. Do like, comment, share and subscribe to my channel Durga Maitreyi. Don't forget to share it to all the music learners. Thank you.